I used to have a simple life. Whatever needed doing round the farm, I'd do it. Being the eldest son, it's tough. But at least we had a living, and our plates were never empty. Then, the war came. I lost everything overnight. The last thing I remember is Father pushing me away, yelling for me to run, to live. At first, I didn't know what to do. Then, I remembered. A story my mother once told me. A story about my uncle, Jordan. He made a modest fortune up north, in a peaceful valley far away from the war. For weeks I held on to that thought, until the valley from my mother's stories, I could see it. This is where I can start a new life.
Alright, so the first quest is to start a new life, and I'm excited to play this game because I've heard lots of good things about it. Apparently it's super in-depth, and you can build a whole village that has people inside of it that does all this crazy stuff for you, and you can build stores, and we're going to get into it. First things first is to go down to talk to Castellan. He's down here at this village. We'll be there in a second. Castellan? Oh, Castellan, where are you? Oh, look at all these ducks. Oh, I could buy them? Okay, cool. Alright, Castellan, are you in here? Oh, that was creepy. Okay, hi. Those eyes, I didn't think I would see them again. One blue as the sky and the other black as a lump of coal. That's funny, my grandma used to describe them exactly the same way. So you're not a ghost. Good. For a second there, I thought I lost it. But your eyes. You look just like him. Sorry, you must have mistaken me with someone. I'm new to these parts. Just arrived at the valley, actually. My name is Rakmir. I'm Wanda's son, aren't you? Lorden's nephew. What? Did you know my mother? Not really. I knew of her. We didn't ever actually meet. He wanted to keep his family separate. I don't think I understand. You will. Wait. What do you mean by did? I know her? Is she well? I hope she is now, wherever that might be. I've lost both my parents in the war. Damn it! This world, I guess it can be as cruel as it is beautiful. I'm sorry, my boy. Nobody should lose their loved ones at such a young age. It's okay. They've died so I could live, and I plan to make the best of this life that I can, in order to honor their sacrifice. Oh, I like that one. That's very mature of you. I'm sure they would be proud hearing that. You mentioned my uncle, Jordan. I actually came here looking for him. Oh, Rakamir, I hate to be the bearer of bad news. Your uncle, Jordan, is no longer with us. He passed away 3 years ago. I'm so sorry. I understand how you must feel. He was a dear friend of mine. So that's it. I'm the only one left. Don't say that. Hey, look at me. This valley is filled with the warm-hearted people who can gladly aid you with whatever you need, and I'm one of them. So what should I do now? You're free to go wherever you like and start a new life. I hereby grant you the permission of the Castellan to build and farm on any unutilized land in the valley. Construct yourself a house and see what comes next for you. You can even build a whole village if you please. There are many travelers passing through. Maybe some of them would like to join your settlement. Just like that, I could take the land free of charge? Well, you'd have to pay taxes to the king annually. But apart from that, you are free to do as you please. As long as you don't break the law, of course. Or at least if you don't get caught doing so. That sounds amazing! The valley looks beautiful as well. I think I'll stay here and see what fate has in store for me. I'm glad to hear that. You can find resources all over the land. Grab a few rocks and sticks from the ground and craft yourself a simple axe. With it, you can cut down trees and chop them into logs. Then you can create a wooden hammer that will be crucial in the building process. I'm sure you'll get the hang of it. When you build yourself a home, come back to Gustavia and talk to my wife, Deborah Neha. She manages the tavern. Ask her to feed you. You must be famished. And then grab some beers for both of us and come back. I'll tell you some stories about Jordan. That sounds like a plan to me. Alright, so it wants us to go and make a simple axe, which should be easy. We're just gonna go straight out here, outside the village, and start collecting resources. I honestly have no idea how to play this game, which is perfectly fine, because that's what this video is going to be for. All these videos. Alright, we got some sticks, now we need some stone. Aha! Found some stone. Alright, now we gotta make an axe. So to open up your radio menu and craft an axe, you press the right bumper, scroll over, press A, choose what you want to make, press A again. Alright, we now have a stone axe. Press Y to equip it. And we need to cut down 5 trees. Alright, we now have cut down 5 trees. Now we need a wooden hammer, which I already know is going to be sticks and logs. So we're going to hit this maple tree again. One more time, pick up all these logs. And now we're going to craft a hammer by pressing right bumper. Going to the handcraftables and doing another hammer. There we go. Alright, and I need 32 straw. And I do know for a fact that I can't actually get straw from down here. These little cattails. I'm gonna need a lot of them. Alright, we've got enough reed. Now it wants us to build our first house. Shouldn't be too difficult. We're gonna just build it right here. Does this look like a good spot? Yeah, for the first house, we're just gonna build it close to the village. I need buildings and houses and small simple house. I want it to be like right here, like this place. All right, so now I believe you need to switch to your hammer. First, we need to equip it. How do I do that? All right, so now that we have the hammer out, we're supposed to go up and smack this thing. Oh, I don't have enough stone. So first, we're gonna have to find some stone. Alright, I found some stone down here by the beach. Looks like there's a lot. Got a new survival level. That's nice. Not sure exactly what that does, but hopefully it's good. I don't know why it wouldn't be. That's 14 stones. Now we have our stones. And then we need to get logs. Now we gotta switch back to our axe and chop up these trees that we cut down. And ta-da! Alright, now to build the walls, we need sticks and logs. You can edit them, change them into walls with windows or doors. How do I switch it to some... Oh, you have to pick which one after that. Okay, so I could switch this to wood or stone if I wanted to. We're just gonna stick with a wattle. We just unlocked a new building, the well. We're gonna have to go get some water here in a second. I need more logs. Rolling away from me! Should be able to do it with one more tree. Now that we've built the house, we have this chest that comes with it, and a cauldron that comes with it, a double bed and a single bed, and that all comes in the house when it's completed building. Now we need to go talk to that dude's wife and get some food. Oh, Deborah! How do I jump? B. Excuse me. Hello, what can I help you with? Hi, you're Debronesia, right? Nice to meet you. I'm Rakamir. Unagust told me that you could fix me up with some food. I haven't eaten a proper meal in weeks. Well, it depends on what proper means to you, but I can offer you something warm and filling. Sounds more than amazing. I got porridge! There you go. Now tell me something about yourself. How do you know my husband? There's nothing much to say, really. I've just arrived at the valley looking for my Uncle Jordan. Didn't expect to be done searching so quickly, to be honest. Oh yes, he was Unigost's friend. I remember how hearing that he had eyes like yours. I'm sorry for your loss. That's okay. I don't even remember him, really. Most that I know about him was from my mother's stories. She always looked up to her big brother. Loved him furiously, even when he stopped visiting. What a dick. A lot of people did, from what I've heard. There was something special about him. Yeah, tough shoes to fill, huh? The only shoes that you need to worry about feeling are your own. Every man is the architect of his own future. Thank you for saying that. It's what I needed to hear. But let's not talk about me anymore. What's your story? I was part of a traveling band of trabadors. I've never managed to learn how to play any instrument, but I was pretty decent with my singing. Our travels brought us to the valley not long after the death of your uncle. I still remember seeing Unigost for the first time. He had so much sadness in his eyes. Jordan wasn't just a friend of his, he was a part of him. The band left a few days later. I stayed. There was something in Unigas' presence that I simply knew my place was by his side. You probably noticed the age difference. No, not really. What? Are you implying that I look old? Nothing of the sorts. Anyways, so it looks like you were anchored here by love. That's pretty amazing. Yeah, you could call it that. Or blindness. Or stupidity. Poor judgment, maybe. Whatever sounds best to you. Pretend all you like. You fell hard for the grandpa with sad eyes and you know it. I did. He annoys me sometimes like nobody else, yet I can't imagine breathing without him now. But don't let me go all soft on you. You're surely got some places to go. Here, I know it's not much, but it will come in handy when starting a new life. Everything costs coin these days. I really appreciate that. Oh, come on. Don't try to be a hero, men. Alright, do something for me, then it won't be a handout, just your first pay. There's a farmer in the village, she's called Jerognuia. She usually supplies the tavern with rye, but I haven't gotten anything from her in a while. My stock is almost gone, and you don't even want to imagine what would happen to these people when we run out of beer. I got two beers. Of course, here you go. Great, thank you, you promised to tell me some stories about Jordan. Oh, I see, well in that case, she gave me more beer. Haha, thank you! Alright, so sleeping can only happen after 7 o'clock, which I don't know if there's a timer anywhere. I don't see time anywhere. Alright, so there's a little bit of time left in the night, in the day sky. We need to hunt a wild animal. We're gonna make this spear, we're gonna try and throw it at this crow right here, it's gonna be great. Alright, I have the spear now. Gotta be nice and slow, and boom! Got him! Alright, well we hunted a crow, now we need a knife. Knife. And now we can skin the crow. Alright, we got 16 feathers and 4 meat, which I'm kind of happy about because I'm assuming that you need feathers to make a bow and arrow, which is something that I really want to make. Should we get some water? And now we got to build a rabbit trap. Furniture, decorations, traps, rabbit trap. I'm just going to run up this hill a little bit and place it out here. Over under these trees. Over under these trees. Alright. Right here. Okay. Alright, so we've got everything kind of set up. We need to eat something. I don't think I'm able to use the cauldron right now, so we're just going to build a campfire. We'll build it right out here in front. And we're going to light it, and then we're going to craft some meat. Alright, now that we have some steak, can I turn this off? No, okay. Alright, now that we have some food and we have some beer, we're gonna go have a story with this guy. See what he wants. Rakmir! Hey, Unigost, you're looking at the proud house owner from the valley. I'm back and bearing beers. A job well done indeed. Alright, let me wet my throat with this amber goodness and start reminiscing. I knew Jordan for 22 years before he died. He was my best and truest friend. A brother, actually. I remember the day we met, as if it was yesterday. I was 25 at the time, living in the big city of Jellinburg, where I was born. You could say that I hated that place, but still, it was the only home I ever knew. Maybe someday I'll tell you more about that. Anyways, I was forced to take care of my own, so I did doing the only thing I could do, stealing. You were a thief? I was, and a bloody good one if I might say. Picking pockets was my bread and butter. I could steal a piece of steak right from your fork and you wouldn't even notice. It wasn't greed that motivated me, just survival. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't enjoy the process. Stealing is still a crime, no matter the motivation. I'd say you'll want to wait and hear a bit more before getting all high and mighty on me. I'm sorry, go on. We had an annual festival at Jellinburg. It always brought a whole bunch of outsiders to town. You can imagine what that meant for a man in my profession. I could do a day's worth of work in a matter of minutes. I grabbed a few coins here and there, some jewelry, a pair of new boots, and then I saw a nobleman with a money bag strapped to his belt. It was basically begging to be set free. I sneaked behind him in the crowd like I did 1,000 times before, child's play. I gently grabbed the pouch, did a little shimmy magic, and there it was, sitting neatly in my palm. Just needed to turn around and disappear like always, and then... WHAM! What happened? I was punched in the face by what felt like a bull, and I was so shocked I didn't even realize what happened until I hit the ground. My head was pounding. I could barely see straight. And do you know what was the first thing I saw next? Another blow coming. Haha, no, a big smile. A big, radiant smile on the face of the man with two different eyes. It was your uncle, Jordan, the one I took for a nobleman. He stuck his hand out, helped me get up, and offered me a beer. Wait, he did realize you were trying to rob him, right? Of course he did. That's just how Jordan was, you see? Your uncle was deadly clever. Smartest man I've ever known. Hands down, he could see the world like nobody else. Predict things. He was always at least a dozen steps ahead of anyone else. So on rare occasions that somebody surprised him, he was intrigued. And he wasn't expecting you? Indeed. Apparently, even despite my failure, I was still the one that came the closest to robbing him, and he liked that. So I'm guessing you accepted his invitation, right? I didn't really have a choice, did I? I was terrified of the guy at that moment. So we went. He took me to the most expensive and most crowded tavern in the whole town. Remember that it was the day of the festival. Even entering that place was next to impossible. He didn't seem to care, though. In the matter of seconds, we were sitting at the table being serviced by two barmaids at the same time. It was surreal. In my mind, there was only one explanation. He owned the place. And did he? Not at all. It was his first time in Jellinburg. It all felt like a dream, to be honest. Especially with me still being dazed after the punch, I was still sure that he was a nobleman. His manners, his clothes, the way he talked and moved, and then he chugged a beer like it was a race, wiped his face with his sleeve, and burped like a drum. He went from the lord to the savage, just like that. I relived that moment a dozen times until I realized why he did that. It wasn't a mistake. Oh no. No laziness. No moment of weakness. He just wanted me to see it. To understand it. Understand what? That he was full of crap. You see, Rakavir, your uncle, was one of a kind. He was a true master of arms, and his weapon of choice was his confidence. What does that even mean? Imagine a closed door with two armed guards at its sides. And you want what's inside? What are your options? You can force yourself in, bribe the guards, try to pick the lock, but Jordan? He just holds his head up high, walks right in, and demands the door be open. You're right. That all sounds surreal. I never knew that about my uncle. My mother's stories were quite different. Because I'm afraid she knew a quite different Jordan than me. Than everybody in the pack. Wait, the pack? Oh dear, Rakmir, there's so much more you still don't know. Our story hasn't really begun, but it's still getting late. Come on, you can't just leave me hanging like that. Alright, I'm going to tell you a bit more after that beer we had. We had a couple of more, and then some meat if I remember correctly. We were talking about our past, our dreams, convictions. Started making some drunk and absurd plans. I thought we were just joking, to be honest. Next thing I remember is waking up in silk sheets. I'm guessing they weren't yours, correct? Are you kidding me? That was the first time I'd even touched fabric like that. The ceiling in the chamber was so high I could fit a giant. I thought I was dreaming. Then the servants walked in. I was ready to flee, but instead of fighting me, they presented me with breakfast. Really? How come? It was all Jordan's doing. I never found out how he managed to pull it off. Whenever I asked, he just burst into laughter. Even years after. Needless to say, I left Yellenberg with him on that day. The first time I went outside of the town's walls, I never came back. That was the day the pack was born. And 3 years later, there were five of us. A real team. A family. We called ourselves the Reminders. Oh wow, I wish I could be there. It all sounds incredible. I've never had adventures like that, and probably never will. Easy, my boy. It wasn't always fun and lovely. But it's a tale for another time. It really did get late, and I'm sure you still have a lot of work to do. Come and find me tomorrow. We'll talk some more. I'll do that. Thank you, Unigost, for everything. It's time to go to sleep.